for the architectural firm, not Batman building, back in the 90s, ESA Architects. So that's the Batman building, and we got the Batmobile building right here.
Now, the Batmobile building. Now, I'm not gonna lie to you guys, I'm a little older than you guys. There is no way you were around when these outfits were in fashion with Batman and Robin. How'd you pick this era of Batman and Robin?
Well, we wanted to pay homage to Adam West, the OG Batman back in the 60s.
The OG, he is the OG Batman. So, you guys, I'm not gonna lie, not many people think, hey, I'm gonna build an aircraft. What would be the best thing to build an aircraft out of? Hey, let's do a building. Well, I mean, just because you guys built that great looking building, you're gonna make a building try and fly?
You ever seen a building fly?
I have never. Has anybody ever seen a building fly? All right, some people have been drinking and in the sun for a little bit today. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. I've never seen a building fly. Let's see if buildings can fly. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Holy Flutop Batman! Let's take a look at that. Let's see if the Robin's going in, if everybody's going in. Give it up for Holy Flutop Batman. Let's watch this replay.
Hey, Rebecca, down there. I have two gentlemen that actually wished you happy birthday as well. They're behind me getting ready to go up. But Aaron, you kind of said you were nervous earlier. What's going on?
I'm not nervous. I'm lit.
Our concept's really digestible. What we do is we're ingredients, and we're gonna use these ingredients to encourage our pizza delivery man, Aaron, who you met earlier, to deliver a giant slice of pizza to Nashville.
Oh, I like that, Aaron. You're gonna deliver the pizza. How fast can you deliver this pizza?
30 seconds or less.
I like it. Ooh, 30 seconds or less. All right, everyone, put your hands together. We'll see if this pizza delivery guy can get to your home.
Time up!
Pizza pie, that's what it is. When the world seems to shine like you had too much wine, that's what it is. Bells will ring, ting-a-ling-a-ling, ting-a-ling-a-ling, and you sing me the belly. Hearts will play, tippy-tippy-tay, tippy-tippy-tay, like you gave that a belly. When the stars make it through, just like a boss, never boss, oh, that's what it is. When you dance down the street with a cloud of your feet, you're in love. When you walk in a dream, but you know you're not dreaming, senor. Excuse me, but I'm missing back
in old me, that's more.
Just as well as Tina does.
It's that Irish skin.
It's the Irish skin.
Wow, I mean, take a look at this team. You guys look pretty good and look like you're ready to fly.
Working on it. Yeah.
All right, so let's go over to you.
All right, Tina, we got H3KCCO-17. Now, when I met you guys in the pits, I asked the team, why did you name it this H3KCCO-17? 17. And I would say unanimously, the other four guys are like, we have nothing to do with this. This is not our idea. This is the dumbest name ever. I hate this name. I hate him. I hate the name. I was like, dude, calm down. It's 9 o'clock in the morning. You just had a coffee. Relax. Take a breath. And then when I went over to you, and what did you say to me?
We named this because of a group number 4 up called The Chive. We wouldn't be here. Yeah, thank you, guys! I want to say thank you to Nashville, to the actual headquarters. We would not be here if it wasn't for them. But we named the team after our motto. The three H's are what the motto of what we stand for, which is human, hotness, and humanity. We champion the underdogs. We want to be the 10% of making the world a better place. Our call sign is for KCCL, which stands for Keep Calm, Chive On. It's when we recognize people in the wild. People who wear shirts that say the same thing, or Bill Murray shirt that has the logo on the back. And that's it, man. We just love to help.
I'm going to cut you off because your team still hates the name, right, guys? You hate the name.
I'm kind of warming up to that name.
Really?
HKC, hold on, I'm going to try to get it. H3KCCO.
Dash 17.
There you go.
Now, I want you to check this out. This is my favorite part. Give it up for Bill Murray on the back of the aircraft, ladies and gentlemen. Chive on, ladies and gentlemen. I want you to put your hands together because they did this redneck backyard ingenuity, glue, PVC, paraffin, and wrap. Let's see what they can do. Just hanging out. Look at that. That's a great shot of Bill right there. Let's see if they all go in. Are they going to keep coming? Chive on! Chive! 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 They all go in. They all go. Let's go to the replay. Right there, that boat
paddle. With the pregnant circus elephant from coast to coast, he rededicated his life to saving danger animals in danger. So
wait, hang on. You based your entire thing off of Smokey and the Bandit. You think the best
I did.
That Bert has ever put out in the world is Smokey and the Bandit 2. No,
funny film.
Now, I have a question for you. Do you think it was a smart idea in 95 degree heat to wear denim jeans, denim shirts, and boots? Because I'm not going to lie, you guys stink like the barge.
Well, we could have worn corduroy, but they're fresh out.
He's the only one that really feels like Burt Reynolds if you've never stopped shaving.
Takes a lot of dedication.
A lot of dedication, guys. Well, let's see if this thing can fly.
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for number 28. Daddy Gators and the Reynolds Refs!
Well, a lot has changed since our beloved Bandit delivered a pregnant circus elephant from coast to coast, rededicating his life to saving animals in need. The world as he knew it took a new direction when he saved his reptile buddy from a group of greasy trackers. He repaid him with loyalty and not eating off his face in his sleep. With giant jaws and shiny feathers, Bert rides him on a saddle made of leather, saving villages along their path from the likes of monsters and villains, all with a massive secret. The alligator never learned how to fly. It was Bert's personal vendetta to see his new friend's dream come true. So in the last ditch effort, the team joined Redwood Blue Talk for one last chance in Florida.
Wow. He openly admitted right there in front of everybody that he knew his craft wasn't going anyplace. I mean, I've had to tell you. By the way, I also like in their story before you judges, it's a personal vendetta to the animal he likes. A personal vendetta to the animal he likes. I'm just saying that you know, I think they were a little all over the board. So we're, I'm taking care of it right now, guys. Right there. Refreshing, delightful, and just so cold, it's perfect. But now, coming up, we have Mongo's Opus. So now, and Anna, right? Anna, why Mongo's Opus?
So we're trying to honor his aviation career and Opus because it's his final song. And also we're trying to honor Nashville and all the national icons. So yeah.
Give it up for that, ladies and gentlemen. Honor it, everybody. Now, you were saying, the guys were saying that your dad was a test pilot? How was that?
Well, he was lots of times a pilot. So he started as a fighter pilot in Marine, and then he went as a test pilot for Hayes International, and then he had a 34-year kind of a Delta.
Wow, give it up for that, ladies and gentlemen. That's really awesome. So now, have you ever flown anything before? If your dad's a pilot, have you ever flown a plane by yourself?
Yes, once it's in the air. I've never taken off the plane, but once I'm in the air, he lets me fly.
So dad helps you take off, and then you take it from there, and then he brings it back and he lands.
Yes.
So, is your father here today?
He is. He looks like Charlie Daniels somewhere.
Hey, if you see Charlie Daniels, tell him thank you. Give it up for Charlie Daniels, Dad. But Dad's not here. He's not on the flight deck. How do you feel about your takeoff, and how do you feel about your landing without your dad?
I feel good about it. He engineered the whole thing, so we put a lot of effort, a lot of time, a lot of thought into it. So I trust him. I trust his design. So, yeah, I'm just going to get out there and pitch and go.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, Dad helped build it. Give it up for Mongo's Opus, number 29. Let's see how they do.
Looking good, you're everything.
Let's see what they can do! They got a little air, a little distance there, Tina, a little distance.
She got away a little bit. I mean, those wolves aren't chasing her very much, though.
No, they're really not. Now they are. And all the wolves are in. Ooh.
Let's take another look at this.
They said they're going to go 350 feet. Let's see what they can do. Tina, you know what I like on their wings? They got fur on the wings, too. They're all about the fur.
No, these guys were so excited to do this event when I talked to them earlier.
Yeah, they have been waiting 10 years.
I'm gonna go get some more.